Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sanjeev Yajnik, Chairman of CCBA.
Good afternoon, folks. It's right getting into the afternoon, but it is wonderful to see the entire community and the leaders across the community of Collin County show up right here in this room. So I want to start, before I start saying anything else, I want to recognize the passion and the leadership of all the people who've shown up today to participate in this very important function. So thank you, and I'd give a big round of applause to all of you who've shown up here. Look, I'm up here on the stage representing the CCBA, so Collin County Business Alliance. And in just a few words, what I would tell you is the reason we created the CCBA is that we believe that businesses have a responsibility to the communities in which we live and in which we live and work and our families are brought up in. And every vibrant community that we've seen has had very vibrant businesses that have stepped up to the plate and have got involved. And I am so excited that the kind of businesses that we have in Collin County have CEOs who are interested in the county in giving back, and that's the reason that we are here today in some ways, because we have partnered closely with the Chambers of Commerce to create forums across Collin County for the elected officials and the elections that are coming up that are so important to our county. So today we're going to have the Plano Candidate Forum, but this is the first of many forums that we've been planning and we have planned with the Chambers of Commerce across Collin County. So the exciting thing about today is that, we also launched hashtag Collin County Votes. And so we've done a bunch of things for the candidates, some of which are 55 candidates across 5 cities have been videoed, and we have that up online. The candidates are using it on their own sites, so that the residents of Collin County can get to know them better. So that's one. We've also used social media, and we've partnered up but led the charge on this. So using social media, we've had, I think, over 900,000 impressions, and it has reached, I think the number is over 65,000 residents in Collin County. And I just want to give a round of applause to all the people at the CCBA and the chambers who have helped us bring all of this media to light on the candidates. So thank you for that. Look, the session that we're going to have today, the forum that we're going to have today, is really important for me for 3 really key reasons. Number one, growth is life. And we are excited that amongst all the states of the United States of America, Texas is the fastest growing, and it's attracting the most amount of talent from within the United States. In Texas, the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex is the fastest growing, and in the Metroplex, Collin County is the fastest growing county. And that is unbelievable, because like I said, growth is life, and along with growth can come many, many great things. However, with growth can come a lot of problems, and there's a great side to growth, and there is all the challenges that come with growth. And therefore, it is so important, which brings me to my second point, our elected officials play an incredibly important role in making sure that we get the good part and we are protected from all the bad part of growth, which is infrastructure challenges and a whole bunch of different things But our candidates and the elected officials play an incredibly important role. And many people don't really internalize that local elections impact our lives far greater than even state or national elections. And there's a bit of a tragedy that in Plano, the total voter kind of a turnout has been in the mid-single digits. And that is really hard. So one of the things that the CCBA wants to do, and we all want to do, is try to get people out to vote. They need to vote their conscience, but we need to keep people in the game and voting, because that is a very important part of managing our growth for the future. And that brings me to my last point. Now, to manage our growth for the future, we need to hear from some of our candidates, and we need to understand where they are going to, the way in which they're going to envision the future. Because remember, the kinds of things that are going to impact us tomorrow and day after tomorrow are as a result of the decisions that we made 2 or 3 years ago. And we need candidates who can cater to the issues today, but they can also have a long-range plan of where we are headed so that we continue to march forward in an awesome way. So this is all about the candidates, some of whom you've seen on video, and for the mayoral race, you're going to see the candidates come up, three of the four, to come up and to have the debate. But I would like to take a moment to recognize and to thank the candidates for the different positions that are being run for today. If the candidates wouldn't mind, please stand to be recognized. If you wouldn't mind, just remain standing for just a minute, for the candidates to stand just for a minute. I would like to also ask for all elected officials currently in Collin County, or who have been previously elected officials in Collin County, please stand to be recognized as well. Phil, you need to stand. Now, please don't sit down yet, please. Please don't sit down. Yes, we saw you trying to sit down right there at the table. Now, here's what I want everyone to appreciate, and I want all these candidates who've been either elected today or have been elected in the past or running for this position, I want to thank all of you on behalf of Collin County. It's not, you don't get into these positions and become rich. This is not, last I checked, unless something has changed. Phil, we should have thought of, though, but this is a labor of love. And it is for the good of the community. And we have been blessed. If there's anything that is going on in Plano today and in Collin County and is leading to the success right now, it is because of the work and the passion and the energy and the selflessness with which you have kind of poured into our county. And on behalf of everyone here, I know everyone in Capital One and all the citizens of Collin County, I want to thank all of you. Thank you. Thank you. And finally, I want to thank two people and recognize them, two leaders of our community right here in Plano, without whom this forum would not have been possible. Key leaders, one is Craig Perry, the chair of the Plano Chamber of Commerce. Please stand. And might I add the word mighty Jamie Jolly, CEO of the Chamber, Plano Chamber of Commerce. So to take us to the next part of today, I would like to invite Craig, the chair of the Plano Chamber of Commerce, to please come up.
Thank you, Sanjeev. Thank you, and thank you, Capital One, for hosting today's event. Wonderful, wonderful facility, and we really appreciate it. Get to my page here. As chair of the Plano Chamber of Commerce Board of Directors, I welcome you to today's program. We also want to welcome the members of Plano Rotary today. They're our partners in this program, so thank you very much. The Chamber has increased its focus on advocacy and accountability at the federal, state, and local levels. Locally, we provided forums to learn about the candidates who wish to guide our great city. Bringing the community together to learn about these candidates for mayor is one of the most important collaborations that we can help facilitate. Plano's become a very diverse city, and we have a very diverse collection of candidates for the most visible position representing the city of excellence. The Chamber is nonpartisan and does not endorse candidates. However, we do support issues and support the upcoming City of Plano and Collin College bond referendums. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce and welcome Jamie Jolly, President and CEO of the Plano Chamber of Commerce and a Rotarian.
I'm glad I didn't have to hop on the stage there. Thank you, Craig. We are so pleased to partner today to bring you this Plano Mayoral Forum. If our candidates can go ahead and make your way to the stage, I've got a few ground rules that I'm gonna lay out for today's forum. First, each candidate will have a minute and a half for opening statements. They will share with you their vision. From there, they will also have 1 minute to respond to each of the questions that will be presented by our moderator. At the end, you will each also have an additional minute to wrap up any thoughts and provide a closing statement. The confidence monitor in front of you will indicate when you are getting close to your time, so please wrap up your thoughts as your time approaches. For those of you in our audience today that have great questions that you would like to ask our candidates, we ask that you do take the index cards located at the center of your tables and put down your questions. And then the volunteers here at Capital One will make their way through the room and collect those cards so that we can ask as many questions as we can during the Q&A portion of the program. Again, we appreciate the participation by all of our candidates that are here today for our forum. And your business community here in Plano is looking forward to hearing from each of you. With that, it's now time to meet our moderator for today's forum, Mr. Scott Sams. Scott is a morning news anchor at KRLD. Scott started his broadcast career at the age of 14, which was probably, 10 years ago, at a very small radio station just outside his hometown of Knoxville, Tennessee. Both of his parents were in and on television in the 50s and the 60s, making Scott a second-generation broadcaster. After 5 years of working at various radio stations, Scott moved over to television. Throughout his 34-year television career, Scott has been in weather, sports, and a news anchor. As an Emmy Award-winning TV talk show host, Scott has interviewed hundreds of celebrities, politicians, and authors, as well as national and international leaders. But he's most excited today to talk to these three right here. Scott and his wife, Lisa, have lived in Lake Highlands, Frisco, and Plano during their time here in North Texas. Please help me in welcoming Scott Sams to the stage.
Thank you, Jamie. Thank you very much. Hi, guys. How are you? Hi, guys. How are you? All right. Good deal. We do have I have 1 minute and 52 seconds to finish this. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. They put me on a clock, so they put you guys on a clock too, okay? So when it gets down to those last 5 or 10 seconds, you gotta wrap up, all right? If you don't, we'll probably have them throwing bread at you, all right? No, sir, you can't talk yet. No, sir, I'm sorry. I have to be fair to everyone, even though I love you, I have to.
Question, because Jamie said a minute and a half, and our email said 2 minutes, so I have 2 minutes for our intro. We need a clarification.
We do need a clarification. We are going to 1 minute and a half, and that was agreed upon by the folks that are running this. Now, before we start this, I know there's a lot of tension in the room, right? It's such an honor for me to be invited to be a part of this. My wife Lisa and I have been living here for a long, long time. And in Collin County, I am Mr. Lisa Sams, and I'm very proud of that. And her mom lives with us now. So her mom is now voting in Plano, in Collin County, and she's voted for the last, she can't hear me, but she's voted for the last two elections here. How many people have Twitter? Whoever you are on Twitter, get out your phones now, because you can't bring them out during the debate. All right? Bring out your phones now. I want you to take a picture of me. My Twitter handle is at Scott Sams News. I'm trying to blow up the local internet. Hello? Hi. Nice to see you. Vote for me. Thank you. All right, good. You all ready?
Ready.
I know I'm joking around, but this is very serious, as you all very well know. So we thank you once again for being here. I'll move this microphone out of the way. Early voting, need to let you know, of course, is April 24th through May 2nd. Election Day, of course, is Saturday, May 6th. It's not too far away, and I'm sure that these folks are counting down the days. We're going to kick off the panel with an opening statement. Please include why you want to serve as Plano's mayor, and we're going to go in this order. Do all your microphones work? Say 1, 2, 3, please.
1, 2, 3, test, test.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
All right, we're good. Ms. Bao, Lily Bao, Ms. Bao, would you please begin us this morning or this afternoon?
Hi, everyone. My name is Lily Bao. I am running for the mayor seat. I came to U.S. to receive my education. I have a bachelor's degree in computer engineering from UMass Dartmouth, receiving summa cum laude, and then I received my master's degree in computer science from Northeastern University in Boston. The reason I'm running is because I love Plano. My husband and I, we are blessed with 4 children, all of whom are enrolled in the Plano Independent School District. We moved here because of education. We moved here because Plano's suburban lifestyle, quality schools, safe neighborhoods, solid infrastructure. However, after we moved here, we find these values threatened by the current policies enacted by the current administration. And that's why I am running, because I'm concerned about the direction. I am all for business growth because I am a conservative. That means I'm pro-business. I believe in limited government, low tax, personal responsibility. I think Plano right now is at a crossroads. And my vision for Plano is that it remains a suburban city with smart suburban growth, that it remains an attractive place for businesses and families so that businesses can maintain the talent pool who find here a good place to live and to raise their family. My hope is that we can lower the property taxes. I would hope to enact effective tax rate, keep our taxes low, but still support all the businesses' growth. I hope my children will one day come here and raise their families here. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Bao. Our current mayor, Mayor Harry LaRosslier.
Thank you, and thank you, CCBA, for hosting this forum, and thank you all for coming. 4 years ago, I came before you and I asked for your trust. And today I stand before you and ask you, I hope I've earned a second chance. Much has happened over the past 4 years since I've been elected. I've been fiscally responsible with your tax dollars. This past year, I led the effort for the first tax rate cut in Plano in the last 15 years. As a result, we have the lowest tax rate in the Metroplex and the lowest debt per capita in all the area. I boldly stood on this stage and I said, as your mayor, there's not a company in this world, if we feel it could add value to our city, that we would not compete for. And since then, we've seen Toyota, FedEx, Liberty Mutual, and recently Boeing join our city, along with many, many more. These businesses bear a huge part of our tax rate and pay 50% of our property taxes. I'm proud to say we've kept our citizens safe. We have the lowest crime rate in the Metroplex, and for our city our size of over 250,000, we are the safest city in America. And over my term, we've increased our public safety positions by over 100 positions to keep our citizens safe. Money Magazine recently named us the third best city in America and the best place to live in Texas. We're named one of the best place to raise a family and the number one place to find a job. My detractors say all this success has resulted in traffic. But in reality, 60% of the police traffic stops in Plano are people who do not live in our city. 3 out of every 5 cars are passed through traffic. And to alleviate that, we've worked on creating mixed-use developments where people can live, work, and play. I look forward to continuing that in the next 4 years. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And now Bill Lyle III. Mr. Lyle.
Thank you. And it's a privilege to be here. It's a privilege to see friendly faces out there today. In the opening remarks, it was said that you don't run for this position to get rich. But as each of you know, more importantly than getting rich is maintaining the wealth that you already have. The greatest wealth that we have does not show up on cash flow statements or balance sheets. It's our personal freedom. It's our freedom from the rule of government. It's liberty. That's what I'm running for. I am a small businessman. I was born in Dallas. I grew up in Richardson, and I came to Plano in 1998 when I moved my small business out of my childhood home and into downtown Plano. Running a small business and a small construction company, a landscape construction company, and running a real estate company has given me ample opportunity to run up against the small government. There's regulation after regulation that does not protect the public welfare, but simply inhibits our freedoms. Many of you here today are small business people, some of you large business people, but nonetheless, we must have the freedom to operate unless there's a protection that is really due the people. I think we need to be free from overburdensome regulation. And so that's the main point that I'm in the race for today. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lyle. Now, all three of you have touched a little bit about your experience, but now I'd like to take for each of you to take 1 minute and tell us why your experience will make you a better leader or makes you a better leader, okay? And Mr. Laracier, Mayor, you will start, please.
My experience in Plano dates back not when I was elected 4 years ago, but 23 years. I took the opportunity, when I came here, the community embraced me. I immersed myself in understanding how I can contribute where I had a passion. I served on nonprofit boards. I served on the chamber board of directors, number of committees, and the board of directors. Served on city boards and commissions, planning and zoning, 6 years on city council. And the reason I'm ripe for this position is because I know what Plano's all about. I know what's in the heart of our community. I know all our past leaders that built this city and passed the baton on to me. And I'm proud to say that all 8 living mayors has endorsed me as the right candidate for our city going forward.
All right, Mr. Mayor, thank you. Mr. Lyle, would you be second here, please?
Sure. My experience, it goes back to my opening statement. It's just as a small businessman. And so boards and commissions and volunteer things, that's wonderful. Those are in my history as well. But the thing that qualifies me to lead our city as mayor is I'm going to ask the tough questions. When a law comes our way, when there's a decision to be made, I'm going to really look at how this affects the people that we are there to serve. And so unless you've bumped your head on these laws before, I don't know that you're really equipped to vote yes or no on them. And until you've had a piece of property and been told you can't do anything with the front 50 feet of it, until you've had a property and been told that you've got to do a looped fire lane. Well, there's no way to do a looped fire lane. It's only 18,000 square feet. The fire truck can't turn around. They tell you to build a cul-de-sac. The cul-de-sac won't fit. So until you've run into these regulations over and over and over again, I don't think you're really equipped to sit and look. Oh, that's my time.
Yes, sir. Thank you for being fair, sir. If we could get someone from the audiovisual to take care of the microphone, we could make sure that happens. I think this works now for you, Mr. Lau. Ms. Bao, would you please tell us about your experience and why it would help you?
Sure. As a high school valedictorian and summa cum laude graduate with an engineering degree, diligence is in my blood. I will bring that same diligence to responsibly performing all the duties as mayor while keeping the best interests of the citizens as my guiding rule. I have varied professional experience. I was a senior design engineer, project lead. Currently, I work as a residential real estate professional. My years of community service in my neighborhood also enables me to understand and listen to various different opinions, but these qualifications, even though they are diverse, is not the most important. The most important is my willingness to be an advocate for all citizens, to representing them with a listening ear. And my conservative value also is an important factor. I am endorsed by the Texans for fiscal responsibility and for other groups. All this will enable me to be your representative and be your voice.
Thank you, Ms. Bell. Okay, we've heard a little bit about your background. We've heard a little bit about your experience. Now let's talk, you brought up a couple of issues. Let's talk about priorities. Two or three priorities, Mr. Lyle, we'll start with you this time. Two or three priorities that would be your top three or one or two if you were elected mayor.
The equal administration of justice would have to be top of the list. I have asked repeatedly of the city for the policy. Once someone is sent a code enforcement issue and they violate the code enforcement issue, they've gone beyond their 12 days to fix the problem, what is the city's policy? The city won't give it to me. Home Depot at the 13th, 14th Connector Street, they've had open storage violations for the last 20 years. Last year, this city council approved a new site plan for them. I was at the city council meeting. I said, why would we approve a new site plan? The current site plan has never been, it's never been followed. It hasn't been followed to this day. Me and a lot of other small businessmen in the East Plano area have been prosecuted over and over and over and over again for this very issue. Home Depot has not been prosecuted. Right, Ms. Mims?
Okay. Now let's go to Ms. Bow. Would you please give us one of your or two of your top priorities if you were to become mayor?
Sure. The first action I will take as a mayor is to repeal part of the Plano Tomorrow Plan. This is the comprehensive plan that has been forced upon the citizens of Plano despite their resounding cries against it. Next, I will work to lower the effective property tax rate of our homeowners. Finally, I will work to restore citizens' faith in our city government by bringing about transparency to our city's finances. I support putting our budget and monthly expenditures online so that taxpayers can see how their money is being spent. Of course, police and fire departments will always be a priority for me. I will support all their need and make sure our city remains to be safe. Business development also needs to continue, big or small. I would hope to support small businesses, and hopefully we need to do more to attract more high-tech companies coming to Plano.
Thank you, Ms. Bell. Mr. Lyle, with all due respect to all of the candidates, just please talk to the audience as a group. Don't single anyone out, please. And if you have comments, we'll maybe get some you all talking to each other, but let's keep it up here and not out there, okay? All right, thank you, sir. Mayor?
So I can't yell at people like I
told you? No, sir, I wouldn't.
Okay, all right.
Not
okay,
an just election year, no, sir.
Okay, my top three priorities, my next term, I'm gonna say it's more of the same. Economic development, that is the driver for our city. We know who we are the economic driver of Collin County in North Texas. So I'll continue to pursue and represent Plano in the best way possible to bring jobs to our city. Secondly, quality of services. Through economic development, we are able to attract businesses that generate the revenues, property tax revenues, sales tax revenues, that allows us to hire the best and the brightest to deliver the quality services to our city. And lastly, revitalization of commercial and residential neighborhoods. On my first term, we initiated what's known as the Great Update Rebate, where we are helping neighborhoods, mature neighborhoods, revitalize themselves. And as a result, we've had over $9 million of renovation in our more mature neighborhoods with about a $1.6 million investment on our part. We'll continue more of the same.
All right, Mayor, thank you very much. Let's talk about taxes. We've talked about property taxes here at Collin County and specifically in Plano. Property taxes are paid by, I think it's over 50%, 52% I think by businesses, right? So they're talking about, and I've heard you all speak of lowering property taxes. And I've heard some of our council candidates talk about lowering property taxes. That's all well and good, but if you lower property taxes and you don't get an influx of income, you're gonna have to cut something. Right? So what would you cut first? Ms. Ballas, start with you.
I'm advocating for effective tax rate. What that means is that local governments should rely on new tax revenue from new taxpayers to pay for the services they demand, as opposed to gouging the existing residents and businesses just because of their property values in rising value. Effective tax rate does not lower, effective tax rate does not cut budget. What it means is we evaluate this year's budget based on last year's budget, but without considering any new tax rule addition. So this year there will be more budget there because there will be new businesses coming in, new constructions. Regardless of the rate adopted, the government should always receive increased revenue from new properties. That's what it is.
All right, so, Ms. Bao, thank you. Mr. Lyle. Yes, certainly. The question is, if you don't get the proposed income that you get and you lower the property taxes, that money's going to have to be cut somewhere in the city government. What would you cut?
I mean, the only thing I would cut is wasteful spending. And so that's not going to be a significant portion of the budget. We already have the lowest tax rate, has been stated. The other thing you have to understand about the tax rate is that the city gets a very, very small percentage of what you pay. And so in order to keep City of Plano the city of excellence and provide excellent service, there's not big cuts to be made. There's little things, I think, that there's wasteful spending, but these things are very, very small that will take a very crucial eye to locate them, figure out a better way to provide the service or a better way to provide whatever it is that can be provided better, and then eliminate them. I think a principle that that would characterize tax from my perspective is just that we have to realize as elected officials that every dollar we take out of our citizens' pockets is the same dollar that was supposed to spend to their benefit. And so we want to try to take as little as possible, but there's not big cuts to be made.
All right, sir. Thank you. Mayor, what's wasteful spending?
Well, it's hard to quantify wasteful spending on a municipal level because we don't really make widgets or things. We deliver service, excellence in service. And so the only way you're going to define, the main way you're going to define wasteful spending is if you're saying someone or a department is not efficient. But the way we reduce taxes in Plano, and I call it the Plano formula, is this. We invest in our people. We invest in our infrastructure. We attract businesses and we raise and diversify a tax rate. As a result of additional revenue, we're then able to reduce the rate. That's what's happened in the past few years, and we're able to enact the first tax rate cut in 15 years. Normally, you cut taxes, or you cut your tax rate, and you reduce services. This past year, we cut our tax rate. We absorbed what's effectively a 3-cent water rate rise for our citizens, and we hired 70 public safety officers. That's the Plano way.
Thank you, sir. Let's talk about the development and the future of Plano. Mr. Lyle, you have a long history here in North Texas. I would imagine that all of you have seen tremendous growth, especially in Collin County. Where do you see Plano 10 years from now?
Right here in North Texas, I hope. Continuing on the path that we've been on from an economic development standard is the way to go. I don't have any beef with the way that our current council has supported economic development. Healthy things, as was stated in some of the opening remarks, healthy things grow. Plano staying the same is going backwards. It's not progress. So continuing to be the leader in North Texas, continuing to attract top talent would be a priority of my mayoral time. And in that regard, I think that the leaders of the past and the current council have done a great job.
Thank you, sir. Ms. Bao, how do you see the future of Plano the next 5 to 10 years?
I see in 5 to 10 years, Plano will be the San Jose or Cupertino of Texas. I would like to bring high-tech companies, especially startups, to be in Plano so that we can be the next San Jose, you know, Silicon Valley for Texas. I would advocate as economic development, we give policies, incentives to encourage startup incubators in Plano. That's what I want.
Thank you, Ms. Bell. Mayor?
So in the next 5-10 years, 5 years is probably short because on council, to truly be a visionary, you have to think 10, 15, and 20 years out. That's what we did when we were on city council back in 05, and many of the initiatives we worked on are coming to fruition today. My vision for Plano is not to be a Cupertino or a San Jose, it's to be Plano. We're gonna be the Plano that we are today. We're gonna be the city of excellence. We're gonna be regional leaders. We're gonna lead in all the areas that we have already. We're gonna lead being one of the safest cities in North Texas. We're gonna have the lowest tax rate. We're gonna be where the jobs are created. My vision for Plano and what I see in the next 10 years and beyond is that we remain a city that is inviting and welcoming to all. And the way we do that is to maintain high level services, hiring the best and the brightest, and then giving them the ability to do their jobs. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. We have seen a lot of growth in business here in Plano. Over the 30 plus years I've lived here, it's gone from a very small town to a huge town. What do you do to keep business here in this, while you continue to get new business, what do you do to keep the people who are already here, the mom and pop stores, the banks, the folks that have been here for a long time? What do you do for them? Mayor, if you'll start.
Okay, so when I was elected in 2013, I was given this position of an already incredible city. But we didn't rest on our laurels. What we did is we decided to raise that bar. We decided to find ways that we can interact and be more responsive to businesses, communicate more, be more transparent. So we do have our financial records online. That's already occurring. We have a dashboard that gives you real-time feedback as how we're doing in virtually every single department across the city. We interact with our businesses. We have an incredible relationship with our Chamber of Commerce. We've helped lead some initiatives to start different programs with human resource folks and diversity and inclusion within the chamber. Those are the initiatives that we do where we communicate with our folks, and that's how we remain vibrant and relevant to them.
All right, sir. Thank you. Ms. Bao, how would you tackle that? I mean, that's a pretty big. It takes a lot of work. You wouldn't be running, right? But what do you do for those businesses that have been here for so long that may feel, even though we love having these big corporations come in, what about the people that are already here? What do you do to keep them here?
I'll take 10 seconds to correct the data, because you just said 52% of our property taxes are paid by business, and that is not true. The real data is this: 55% of property taxes are paid directly by houses, and 7.1% of our property taxes are paid by condos and apartments. That altogether means 62% of our property taxes are from residential, 38% is non-residential. And property taxes include taxes on equipment and inventories that are paid by businesses. So in order to come back to your question, in order to encourage and keep those small businesses here, first of all, we need to lower our property taxes. We do not want to be a burden to any businesses. And second of all, in order to retain this, last week the Dallas Morning News had this interview, and Mr. Carahan was saying, why do we get, you know, Boeing come to here? Is because the questions he was asked over and over again is, how can we retain the talent? In order to retain the talent, most important, we keep Plano suburban. We keep Plano top quality schools. That's why people are here.
Okay, Ms. Bao, thank you. Mr. Lyle, I want you to answer the question, and then I want to get back to the differences in the taxes and how they're paid. Mr. Lyle, would you please tell us?
So the question that I recall is talking about mom and pop businesses and keeping people that are already here.
Keeping businesses here.
Yeah, I mean, we have a diverse tax base, and so we've got to continue that. The mom and pop businesses, just this is a broken record, but you got to reduce regulation on them. You can't have the same development regulations on someone that owns a 20,000 acre site that's in East Plano, the same development regulations for a Toyota campus. There's got to be a concession made for smaller pieces of property to keep the small business person here and able to develop, invest in their property, invest in their office buildings. But when you overregulate them, you know, I had a meeting this week with the planning director, and he was just talking about facade requirements and how people wanted to redo their facade, redo their building. And when they figured out what the standards were, well, they said, well, we can't do that. We're just going to have to repaint. And so it's finding the balance that doesn't put too heavy a burden on those mom and pop businesses.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Lyle. Ms. Bell, I want to come back to you for a second. The information that I was given says that 52% of the taxes, and as you corrected me, are paid by businesses. Can you please tell us where you get your numbers of 62% versus 38%?
I think the 52% or the 50% the city is saying is because we, for property value, appraisal values, 50% of those are from residential. However, there are government buildings, churches, there's, you know, about 3% of all our property, you know, value, they don't pay property taxes. They are exempt.
All right, but
yes,
but
and then there's others. So,
but if they're government buildings or they are churches,
but
they're not business.
They don't contribute to our property tax income.
But they're not business, right? All right, Mayor,
Hello? Yes.
You're there.
Okay, thank you. Well, to a certain degree, I think my opponent is inaccurate, and we'll give her a pass. You know, over the past 3 years since you've lived in Plano, maybe you don't know how we account for our businesses.
Hang on.
But
hang
here's
on.
How it works. Here's
hang
how
on,
it works.
Hold on, Mayor.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me.
I don't mind.
Let me just say how we
All
do
right.
that.
Go ahead.
Basically, the way it works is businesses pay over 50% or slightly over. That includes multifamily as part of businesses. And so
okay.
when you add that, that plus the businesses is counts at corporations and such adds to the 50%. 50% of the property taxes are paid by residents, and so everything else is paid by those other entities. But you know, churches are tax-free entities, and certainly the government is as well.
All right. Thank you very much. Now, go ahead.
You know what?
Just for about 30 seconds, okay?
Yeah, less than that. I can publish that on my, you know, on our website, how we got to this number, but we can go on with other questions.
Okay.
I definitely stand by my number.
I understand. We've had some of the folks here. We've had a couple other questions that we had scripted here, but I want to go with some of the questions from you that have been in, but just for time purposes, because we've got about 10 or 15 more minutes here before we're done. Ms. Bao, this is a question for you. I better put on my glasses, sorry. I've been here for a long, long time. And these are trifocals, by the way. Okay, Ms. Bao, this question is for you. It's from someone in the audience. You ready? And you'll have, we'll have 1 minute to answer, okay? You told the audience that pro-business and the like in Plano to develop economically. Business helps to reduce taxes and provide funds for new facilities and growth. But in that case, why have you been opposing construction of residential facilities?
Residential facilities?
I'm gonna guess it's apartments.
Right. I'm not opposing all kinds of apartments. Like Legacy West, I think that's a very good area. They have their special case. They don't have any suburban neighborhoods around them. That's just a very special case. You know, whatever, you know, high-end apartments developing there, we're fine. We are against the massive construction of high-density housing everywhere in Plano.
Yeah.
If you are not aware, do you know that Plano is the third densest city in Texas? We already have 34,000 apartments with another 11,000 units approved. Right now, our ratio between apartments and single house residential is 32%. If we add the 11,000 that has been approved, that will put us above 40%. We are not lacking of apartments. I'm not against apartment dwellers in any way. I lived in apartments for a long time. Everything is a balance in life. Why did people move here? Why do we have all those corporations coming here? Because we have a good pool of talents because of you, because you are here.
Ms. Bowen, sorry, we're out of time there. You went over your time. Mr. Lyle, would you answer that question, please?
The most important thing I can do is back up. I made a mistake earlier. I let my passion for liberty take me somewhere that I should not have gone. And so I think the most important thing that a leader can do when they publicly make a mistake is publicly acknowledge it. And so I'd ask the audience and Ms. Mims to forgive me.
You now have about 30 seconds to answer the question.
Great. High density, multi-use properties, they're the thing of the future. It's the solution, it's not the problem. Yes, they need to be in specific areas, but Legacy West is not the only specific place that it makes sense to do it. The council, I think, has been on the right track here as well. Razor Road, Legacy, these are some projects that didn't get passed, but it would help those areas. It creates a little hub within the city where folks can live, work, and play. It's not my line, that's the city's line, but I'm for those developments. Thank you.
Mayor?
So our current comprehensive plan actually is less dense than our 1986 plan. It prescribes and it projects less apartments than our 1986. Since I've been elected, over 90% of the apartments that have been approved have been in multi-use facilities or mixed-use facilities areas, such as Legacy West, downtown Plano, Heritage Creek. And so we've been consistent that from a residential standpoint, we're pretty much built out, but there are places where we actually can reduce traffic and provide employment opportunities, living space and workspace and play space, so to speak, within a tight radius. And so most of the apartments, like I said, over 90% of apartments built since I've been mayor have been in Legacy West, downtown Plano, and Heritage Creek, which is a new mixed-use facility right. Coming online.
Thank you, sir. We kind of got on that fringe, didn't we? Let's be positive, okay? Let's be positive. Let's talk about what you think is the best asset that this city has to offer, Mr. Lyle. Some of the best assets. You don't have to single one thing out.
The best asset for the City of Excellence is our excellent people, which is why I continue to be for less regulation. We have good people. We have moral people. That's one of the things that contributes to the low crime rate amongst an excellent police department. But the best thing we have is our people, and I want to free the people to do for themselves and provide for themselves and get the government as much out of their way as possible. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lyle. Ms. Bao?
Me?
Yes, please.
The best asset definitely is the people, the residents of Plano. You are the residents, you are the people who make this place a great place. And the diversity we have people from all over the world, of all kinds of educational background. I'm one of them, I'm running, and you see how diverse we are. In order to keep, and the other asset is our suburban neighborhood and quality schools. If we lose all these things we treasure as Plano residents, Plano can be gone. Business can leave. People can move away. And that's why I'm running. I am running to protect Plano. If you have businesses here, even if you don't live here, you should care. What kind of Plano in the future you want to see? You want to see a suburban neighborhood with vibrant, vibrant suburban neighborhood, with businesses coming? Or do you want to see that we have too many high density housing and people are fleeing? What kind of future do you want to see? And the choice is very simple. You see our differences.
Thank you, ma'am. Mayor?
Well, the best quality about Plano, obviously, is our people. Not only our people that live here, but the people who work here. We have about 2,000 plus employees that go in day in and day out, and they're just passionate about the service quality that we give to our citizens, and our citizens come to expect that. But really what has been the great part about our city is our prior leaders that had that vision years ago to put us in the position we are today, where we are reaping the benefits. And two, our responsibility, certainly mine as mayor, is to look out in the future and be that welcoming committee, welcoming city that will embrace everyone. You know, when I came here 23 years ago, you know, this city embraced me open arms. And my Plano, the Plano that I'll be mayor of, is one that's going to be supportive and inclusive of everyone, whether they live in a condo, an apartment, or a single family home.
All right, so thank you. They've all done well, haven't they? Yeah. We're going to take this final few minutes here to get closing statements from you. And so, Mr. Lyle, if you will start, you will each get 2 minutes for a closing statement. Mr. Lyle.
About 20 years ago, I was at a transfer station. It's where you throw trash. And there was a book, a box of books. And I picked one of the books up, and I just flipped the pages. And there was a quote that went something like this. It said, "I can't put it to you too strongly or too often that it is your practical advantage to learn America's character and problems in the broadest possible way. Every time we allow or force the government to take over a question that properly belongs to us, by that much we surrender our individual liberty and with it a comparable amount of freedom. But the very core of Americanism is individual liberty, founded on individual responsibility, equality before the law, and a system of private enterprise which aims to reward according to merit." That sums up my candidacy. Get the people free, reduce regulation, continue all of the great things that we already have, continue the development, continue the low tax rate, continue the excellent public service. But I've said it over and over and over again, it's one size does not fit all when it comes to big and small business. And where we can, we need to reduce the burden on the economic engine of our society, which is small businesses. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your time.
Ms. Bao, would you be second, please?
Plano is at a crossroads. Like many of you, my family moved here because we loved the suburban neighborhoods, excellent schools, safe communities, and sound infrastructures. Yet, you got to realize all these are quietly changing. The policies that have been enacted by the City Council in the last 4 years are eroding away all these precious attributes that we treasure as Plano residents. As your mayor, I will protect Plano's future by carefully evaluating land use proposals that provide for optimal traffic control, flow, prevent school overcrowding, and keep Plano suburban. I will support business development. I would like to see us have more high-tech companies coming in. But most of all, I would love to lower our property taxes, bring transparency to our city's budget. I will respectfully listen to citizens, keeping your best interest as my guiding rule in all decisions that I make on your behalf. As I told you, I am endorsed by 5 organizations, including Texans for Fiscal Responsibility. As business owners, I think tax is always your concern. I believe in conservatism. I believe in small government, less government, more governance. Less government, more governance. That's what I will stand for. Thank you for your support. I hope to get your vote. Together, we will protect Plano, keep Plano suburban, make Plano more prosperous, and have a greater future for our children. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Bao. Thank you, Ms. Bao. Mayor.
My vision for Plano is that we remain a world-class city, a diverse city, a city that has an abundance of recreational, educational, and cultural opportunities, a city that is prepared to compete on the global stage for any business, family, or individual looking for a place to call home. My vision for Plano is a city that everyone is welcome with open arms, a city that is safe, a city that's a big city yet feels like it has a strong sense of community. We'll continue some of the initiatives we've worked on in the past, such as the summer internship program, where this about a month ago, 350 Plano ISD rising juniors and seniors were right here in Capital One, getting prepared to possibly get internship jobs to prepare and connect as the future workforce. A community that embraced an initiative to feed hungry children in our schools, 1,500 children every weekend for the whole school year. That's the city that I look to lead and I want us to continue. I'll be a mayor that manages the city with knowledge, intent, and integrity. I'm humbled by the support I've received from past leaders. Again, every living mayor has said to me, they support me because they think I am the best choice. I am supported by the Plano Fires Association, Plano Police Association, and the Collin County Realtors Association as well. 4 years ago, I asked for your vote. I asked for your trust. This year, today, I ask you, tell me if I earned it. If I delivered what I said I would do. I'm Harry LaRosse Lierre, the mayor of the City of Excellence, and I ask for your vote. Thank you.
Really good job, Bill. Good job. Ms. Bell, nice to meet you. Good job. We do appreciate all of their participation. You want to have a group hug real quick? See, that's America. That's the beauty of it. You can be. That's what it's all about. Early voting again, April 24th through May the 2nd. Election day is Saturday, May 6th. You can go to the City of Plano's website to get polling locations. Don't leave yet. In addition to today's candidates, the May ballot will feature bond referendums for the City of Plano and Collin College. CCBA, proud to join the Chambers of Commerce across Collin County in their support of Collin College bonds referendums. There's more information on the table outside. Now, once again, I'd like to bring up our host.
Thank you. Thank you. Sorry. Thank you, Bill. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, wasn't that unbelievable? Wasn't that amazing? Look, at the national level, they should be eating their hearts out if they can only have the presidential elections happen the way these ones did, right? Look, I just want to say thank you so much for your energy and your passion. Plano is an unbelievable city, and all of us participating and helping make this election process a success would be just amazing. So thank you all for coming here. And I end with thanking our wonderful, great facilitator. Please stand up to be recognized, Scott Sams. Did an amazing job. We love the way in which all of us get together. It just feels like one family. Thank you so much. Have a great afternoon.